Hello, I hope you all are doing well. So today I have my Sephora Spring Savings Event haul. So I absolutely love Danessa Myricks. I love her products, so I went ahead and used this as a chance to pick up a few items from her that I didn't already have, because I already have a lot of Danessa products because I love them. She's a Black founder and amazing makeup artist, so I definitely knew I wanted to support her and get a few more of her products during the sale. So I got the Yummy Skin, the serum skin tint. Today I'm wearing her Yummy Skin, the blurring balm. So I love that. If you don't have that and you want something that is light and does not feel heavy on your face, I definitely recommend trying that. Here is mine. I have it in the shade 6. So it's amazing. Now it does have a scent to it, like it smells almost like minty. So I do want to mention that just in case you're sensitive to scents. But I got the shade 7 in the serum skin tint. Now I thought 7 would work since I had 6 in the other one, but this 7 looking a little light, child. But I do have her contouring balm, and I also have like blushes from hers, so I can make it work. If this is a little light for me, I can wear it in the winter time, or I can make it work by like underpainting with the cream bronzer and then applying this on top. But yes, so there's that. It does look like it's going to be a little light, but I'm not sure. And then I got the Yummy Skin, the serum foundation. This one I got in the shade 13N. And again, it's looking a little light, but I can always underpaint and just make it work by using cream contour, cream bronzer, powder on top, and really just blending it. So I could kind of use this on the center of my face and then use bronzer and contour. So yes, next time there's a sale, I will probably pick these up in darker shades just in case these are too light. But in the meantime, in between time, I'm gonna make them work. And then I have been seeing this go viral. This is the Yummy Skin Water Powder Serum from Danessa Myricks, and I definitely wanted to try this here. Now I have dry to combination skin, but what I thought I could do with this is kind of use it in the areas where I tend to get oily, which is my T-zone area. I have been wearing the balm, this here. What is this again? The Yummy Skin, the blurring balm powder for face and eyes. I've been wearing this for about 5 hours now, and it still looks great, but I can kind of feel and see the shine like on my nose, which is normally where I get oily. My nose, pretty much my T-zone. So I got this because I've seen like Uche using this and swearing by it, saying it's amazing. So I just wanted to give that a try because it's getting hot and I want to like stay matte, especially in my T-zone area. So that was all I got from Danessa Myricks. And then I wanted to try one of the Brown Girl Jane fragrances. So I didn't know which one I wanted, so I purchased the Discovery Set, the Brown Girl Jane Discovery Set. And this one comes with 6. Yes, it comes with 6 different fragrances in these little like trial sizes. It comes with, I think these are all, I think she only has 6. So there's one that I don't think is on here, and I think that's the one I want, but it's, I think, Carnival or Carnival. Like, that's the one that I think I'm going to get. But just smelling this, like, this smells mad good. So another black owned brand at Sephora, so I definitely wanted to support and try, and I'm going to buy one or two of the full size fragrances once I figure out which ones I want. And then of course I purchased Forever Mood, the fragrance launch. I purchased all four of them, but two I had to purchase directly from Forever Mood because they were sold out on Sephora. I bought them when they launched. This was before the sale. But yeah, I don't have I Am Her because I ordered I Am Her from Forever Mood and they accidentally sent me NDA instead of I'm Her, but they fixed it. They didn't ask for the NDA back and they refunded me because I'm Her since sold out on the Forever Mood website. So yes, when it comes back in stock, either on the Forever Mood site or Sephora, I will be purchasing I Am Her. And then I re-up on my faded patches from Topicals. These are the brightening and clearing eye mask. So I got another set of these during the sale, and then I also got the Topicals, the Slick Salve, the what is this? This is the mint lip balm. And so here it is. And the applicator, I love how the applicator looks because it's kind of like to really hug your lips. And it smells minty. And yeah, it says that this really like softens and restores your lips and that it stays on. Like, so I love that. I love when a lip product, especially like a gloss, when it stays on the lips, or like a lip balm when it stays on. I don't like to have to keep reapplying. So if it's sticky, I don't even care about that. That doesn't bother me personally. So I'm excited to try that. And then sticking with supporting black owned brands in Sephora, I got the Ami Colay. This is the skin enhancing stick. So I got this one and I got it in the shade 310. So here's what it looks like. This looks like it's going to be a good color match for me. So I got this. And then I also got the lash amplifying mascara from Ami Colay, and I got my lash extensions taken off a couple months ago and I haven't gotten them back. I think I've developed an allergy to the adhesive, so I just wanted to get some good mascara. So I have this, and then I also bought the Hella Thick from Fenty Beauty. That's one of my favorite mascaras, so I bought this one because I heard great things about it. So yes, those were the two products that I got from Ami Colay, and I definitely want to get some of their, I think it's lip oils, and then they have like some blush sticks, so I definitely want to get those next. But y'all, I done bought so much stuff. I'm like, girl, like, pace yourself. Like, calm down a little bit. I got these. These are the cotton pads from Sephora. I like to use these with my micellar water, like when I'm making sure I'm taking my makeup off. So I like to use the matte cleanse off oil and then micellar water, Garnier micellar water, and the matte cleansing oil to remove my makeup. So I bought these pads from Sephora. I currently use like the deluxe ones from Target, but I saw raves about these ones from Sephora, and all Sephora collection stuff was actually 30% off during the sale. So yeah, I'm like, this makes them the same price as my Target ones, and these are organic cotton pads. So I'm like, okay, let me try them. So I bought two. And then I did get a few other Sephora brand products. I got multiples of the Sephora Micro Smooth Powder. I think I got two other shades, but I don't know where they at. But yes, micro smooth powder. I got my regular shade for my face. This is shade 40 tan, which I think has been discontinued, the shade 40 tan. And then I got shade 58, and I got shade 25 to set under my eyes, and then I think it was shade 70 to like contour with. These were on sale for $7 during the Sephora sale, and then an additional 30% off because all the Sephora brand was 30% off. So I thought that that was a great deal to stock up. So these are normally $20, so I got four of them for the price of one during the sale. So yes, and then also from Sephora collection, I got this colorful luminizer, and here it is here. This one is in shade 01 glitzy gold, so I thought this was really pretty. And then I got two of the Sephora Outrageous Effect Plump glosses. I got shade 02 XXL nude, and then I got shade 11, and this is Starstruck Pink. So I got these two lip glosses, and then I got some One Size Beauty, which is Patrick Starr's beauty brand, and I got the Turn Up the Base, the Beauty Blur Balm. I'm really into like these blur balms because I love like the no makeup makeup look, or like, you know, just nice soft makeup, especially as it's approaching the hotter months. So I got the shade medium dark 2, and here it is here. So yeah, I wanted to give this one a try, and I love like the applicator on this one because you press the side and then you can squeeze it out. Like, I thought that was so cool, just the design to this one. Then I got the Secure the Blur, the makeup magnet primer. I love primers, y'all. Like, I love primers. Primers can definitely be a game changer when it comes to the look of your makeup and how long your makeup lasts. So I heard great things about this primer, and then also just trying to make sure I'm not just a hot sweaty mess during this heat. Like, if you live in the South, then you know about this heat, and this heat ain't nothing to play with. So I got the Secure the Sweat primer as well, and I saw people putting this on going to the gym working out, child, and their face was still sitting afterwards. I ain't finna do all that, but I do want my makeup to last and look great when I'm wearing it now that we're into spring, and it's only getting hotter. It's only getting hotter. So I got that primer, and then I got the One Size Beauty, the Ultimate Setting Powder, and this is in the Ultra Pink. I've seen people using pink setting powders, and I wanted to give it a try. So yeah, I got this pink setting powder for setting my concealer under my eyes, and I'm excited to try it and see how I like it, because I either use like a foundation powder, or I'll use translucent or like a yellowy, like banana style powder when I set my under eyes. And I've seen that the pink looks so beautiful, and it gives almost like a unique, like almost like an angelic look to it. So I want to give that a try and see how I like it. Okay, let's make sure we went through this box. Now we got a few more things in this box before we get to the second box, y'all. And I know, like, I am on a no buy currently, so yeah, I did too much during the Sephora and Ulta sales, but I'm on a no buy. I'm going to be shopping my closet and using this makeup that I bought. Also, another black owned brand, and this is LYS Beauty, and I really want to get their blush sticks. They look so beautiful. But what I did get is the No Limits cream bronzer stick, and I got it in the shade Courage. So here's the packaging, really beautiful, and here's the bronzer stick. So I cannot wait to use this because I've really come to love like bronzers and cream contours. I feel like, especially if you got foundations that's too light, like it will be my wintertime foundations, the shades, and I'm like, oh, I don't want to have to buy another summer shade. I want to make this work. Cream bronzers and cream contours are perfect for underpainting or just adding warmth and color to the outer portions of your face and helping to blend foundations that's too light, honey. So yes, love this. It's so creamy and just smooth. I tried it out in Sephora. I need to get some of those blush sticks. So when I'm done with my no buy, I'm gonna get some of those. And then I was trying to find like a good concealer, so I got the, what's this, Kofi, how you pronounce that, I don't know, May Match concealer. So I got this concealer, and I got it, what in the world, extra Alachi, man, there's the concealer, I don't want to be mispronouncing stuff. And I got this for under my eyes. That's where I use concealer. I use it under my eyes or like to conceal my brows after I, you know, do them, since I started back doing my brows, honey. So I really don't use concealer on my face. So typically when I buy concealers, I buy like brightening concealers that I can wear underneath my eyes to give like a nice pretty bright look. And another concealer that I got is the Fenty Beauty, the Wear Even, the Hydrating Long Wear Concealer. And here it is, right here. And I got it in the shade 300 Neutral, again, for that bright under eye look. Then I wanted to try like some new foundations, like foundations, and not like the skin tints or anything like that. So I got this foundation from Urban Decay. This is the new Face Bond foundation. It says waterproof foundation up to 24-hour wear, 3% niacinamide, can't feel the coverage. And this is supposed to be like, it says lightweight, medium buildable coverage, and it's also supposed to be self-setting. Woo child, that's a lot of claims. And I got the shade 23 medium neutral. So here's the shade that I got, 23 medium neutral. And I really want to start getting back to like reviews, because oftentimes, you know, we're making blind purchases off of seeing someone else haul something, but I want to start doing reviews. Hold on, see somebody on my camera. I just want to get back to doing reviews, doing wear tests, telling you how a product lasts, and showing you putting it on and then coming back a few hours later. I've been seeing people talk about this like on social media, on TikTok and stuff, and I remember when that was the way things were done on YouTube when it came to like product reviews, like actually trying the product. So I want to get back to that. So I'm going to do that with this foundation and these other foundations. I'm going to do wear tests. I'm going to try them with primers, without primers, with setting spray, without setting spray, and just let y'all know the full thing. So it's going to take me about a week to do each of these foundation reviews, but I feel like it's going to be worth it because just getting back to being informed, it helps us to be informed as consumers by seeing if something's going to work before we buy it. So yeah, I'm going to do that, and I think it's going to be good. I think it's going to be nice. So then I got the Haus Labs foundation, and this is Lady Gaga's makeup brand. And when I tell you, so many of the Haus Labs products looked appealing to me. The blushes looked gorgeous, but I'm like, okay girl, take it easy. So I got the foundation. Ooh, this feels nice. This heavy. It has a pump. The shade that I got is 340 medium cool. And yeah, so here's how it looks. This is heavy. Like, this feels good. It feels such great quality. The blushes look gorgeous. So I'm excited to try this foundation. And again, give you a wear test, talk about performance, show you it when I apply it with a timestamp, show you as it progresses throughout the day, and just give my final thoughts after wearing it and trying it again. With primer, without primer, with setting spray, without setting spray. So I'm really excited about like doing makeup reviews because I really do love makeup. And then the last box, honey, I got the Cinema Secrets, the makeup brush cleaner here. And then I got the Olay Henriksen Transform. This is the Glow 2O Dark Spot Toner. I got the little small one because I just wanted to try this out. I haven't tried it before, so I'm like, let me just get the small one. And then I also got the Charlotte Tilbury, the Airbrush Flawless Setting Spray. And here it is right here. Again, I got the smaller size version because I've never went through a whole bottle of setting spray unless it's Fix Plus, because I just be Fix Plus in multiple stages throughout my makeup. But yeah, I just wanted to try it out, honey, because this ain't cheap. This was pricey. So I got the little trial size to try it out, but I've heard great things about it. I want my makeup to last. If I'm going to be taking the time to do my makeup, I want it to last. And I also got the One Size Beauty Until Dawn Mattifying Waterproof Setting Spray. Again, I want my makeup to last. If I'm taking the time to do it, I want it to stay on my face. So, yes. And then I got another foundation. This was a recommendation I saw on TikTok, and they said that this is like a sleeper foundation that is mad good, but a lot of people don't really know about it. This is the Shiseido Revita Essence Skin Glow Foundation. It also has SPF 30, and I got shade 420 Bronze, and packaging really gorgeous, and I think this is a good shade match. Because with these, I actually put in like foundations that I have that I love the shade, and then Sephora shade matched me to those. With the Danessa Myricks skin tint, I didn't do that. I just went off of my shades being 6 in the other one, and I was like kind of winging it. So I did get 2 brushes from Sephora. I got the 56 brush. This is the Pro Foundation brush. And here's what it looks like. You can see it better on the box, honey. This is the 56 brush. And then I got the Sephora Pro brush, the number 50. And this is the powder brush. So I got these 2 brushes. Again, Sephora collection was 30% off during the sale. I got the Pat McGrath concealer, another black owned brand, and this is the Skin Fetish Sublime Perfection Concealer. I got it in the shade LM12. really substantial packaging. This is nice and sturdy and heavy. And again, I got this for underneath my eyes for a brightening effect. And I really want to get the foundation too. And I want an eyeshadow palette and a blush and an eye powder. So I'm already kind of planning out my next Sephora sale haul in my mind, because I'm like, okay, I'm gonna use the stuff I got this time, and I'm going to kind of like wait until the next sale, and then I'll get the other things. You know, I'm good with what I got. Have more than enough. Went too crazy as it is, but have more than enough to do my face and really be able to try some new makeup and hopefully find some new favorites, because I am a creature of habit. A lot of the products that I use when I do my makeup, it's products that I've been using for years, because once I find what I love, I just stick to it. So I'm excited to actually be trying some new products. So let me know down below in the comments, did y'all get anything from the Sephora sale? Have you tried any of these products that I bought, things that I haven't tried yet? Let me know your thoughts down below in the comments. Are they good, girl? Are they not good? Like, please help me out and let me know. And then if you have some holy grails, your faves, let me know what those are down below in the comments, so that I'm ready and prepared for the next Sephora sale, because things are going into the cart, into my favorites, my loves, but that's for the next sale, honey. Next sale. Sephora can't get no more of my money until the next sale. So if you made it all the way to the end of the video, honey, thank you so much for watching. I hope you are doing well. If you haven't already, you can check out my uploads. I've been posting regularly. You can come back on Sundays and Wednesdays. Ooh, I was about to say Sundays and Mondays. Sundays and Wednesdays for new uploads. And yes, so thank you for all the support. Thank you for watching. And I'll see y'all in my next video.